Hey everybody, so today we're coming at you with a recipe that I've never seen before, but I think it's going to work, so we're going to give it a try.
Shorts are on, legs are out, plunging into the water.
That dog was the coolest. He could catch frisbees. He could jump like 4 feet in the air.
Look at me! Look at me! I'm a grown man now. I don't shit on myself no more, you black
stick. You shit all the time on yourself.
Who knows? Maybe there is some kind of firmament. Some kind of firmament. And we're underwater. We could be underwater. Maybe there's water above the firmament and then water down here.
Whoa. I mean...
Good morning, niggas.
Who said they were Jewish? Who made it about Jews? Not us.
I am a federal agent. I will never shut down a storm. Whoever's in charge is in charge. The Armenians are down. I'm not worried about Minos. I'm not worried about Russia. Anybody worried about Putin?
Because
this is his pussy.
Really, like the 95, 95, 95. You know?
I did everything right and they indicted me.
I'm gonna get my head screwed on straight and stop being nasty.
For the hell, we have plans to build a railroad from the Pacific all the way across the Indian Ocean. We have plans to build in Angola.
Because all you black men are reneging.
Huh?
It's called 1.8 million in gold. You want it? Go to Africa. We gave a black beach back. You don't want it? Stay here. Get off our line. It's the whites and the Latins. Anybody got a problem with it? Because I'm Indian too. I'm Vietnamese. This bitch is trying to free the world.
Come on. You just don't you worry your little sweeties, okay? All right. You're in charge. You're going to find out real fast.
Welcome to War Mode.
Chewie's up. Caitlin's done. Her dog is a Great Dane. Is he allowed to shit all over my house? Who is allowed to shit on me? Who shit in the streets of IMT? That snitch, Caitlin. So all these white bitches that think they own something, I'm not afraid. Do you want a word, nigga?
How do I go from Johnny B. Good to my French bulldog bleeding to death? Oh, yeah. I'm really pissed off.
Hierarchy in the kind of the Jewish population. But anyway, I really wanted to be a Jew, and then I found out that I was really a Nazi. You know. Because my family was German, Hartmann, which also gave me some pleasure. So I'm kind of, yeah.
Sir?
I, what can I say? I understand Hitler.
Yeah, we're good. We don't got to do all that. Yeah, that fucking... I never understood any of those, like that sea, the submarine shit. I would never fuck with that. Like yeah. Being that down low, dude, with like just, I couldn't imagine staring at fucking five people while you just slowly run out of oxygen.
No, not for me, bro. I mean, I don't think I'm claustrophobic, but fuck that.
That, yeah.
That's a coffin. You have to think that.
You have to sit there with six people and fucking just slowly
die. You know you're pissing. People are pissing. People are shitting.
Yeah. All to see the fuck. It's weird as fuck to want to go see the Titanic. Because it is kind of like a fucking like graveyard.
Well, the one dude's been to space, though, so he might be able to tell you about the curve.
Which dude?
One of those dudes down there has been to space. He's been to fucking... He's been... The chick said he's been to space.
Yeah, I mean...
He's a billionaire. He's an explorer.
It's weird that all those dudes, all they want to do is like either go to the bottom of the ocean or try to get out of the fucking glass jar.
Yeah.
Dude...
I was getting into a thing, like, you fucked me up with then all that weird
shit
you're talking
about. Oh, fuck, I forgot. I got you on the caves.
Fucking destroyed me. But one thing I thought that was very suspicious was the whole time that we were running the Apollo program in the 70s, the Russians were like, have at it. And they dug down. They're the ones that...
They did the 7-mile hole.
The Russians, it's 9.2 miles.
It's 9?
Yeah.
Oh, they were saying it's 7.8 on level with me.
No, this was fucking nine miles down. And when they got down there, the pressure was too hot. There's no tools that we have.
It's just melting bits.
Too much heat, too much pressure, but there's gas coming out. There's nitrogen's coming out. So they're like, dude, how's gas down here? So we don't know what the fuck. is in the middle of the world.
Dude.
It's all theory, bro.
That like that's what I'm saying. This is what like pisses
then
me off.
I got into a world of fucking different. I mean, you fucked me up. I'm sitting here. I'm like, I'm going to set up an office. I have this thing going on where I have all these books, and I'm going to do it like the I Ching or like tarot cards. I'm just randomly grabbing books, reading like 20, 30 pages.
You're so interesting.
Taking what
so
I,
hot.
Taking what I can get from them, you know?
Are you going to be that dickhead who just starts holding a book at the bar?
I mean, am I going to be jacked with a book at the bar? Probably.
Dude, I never really gave it a fair shake. Like in the mirror, I have a big ass mirror in my fucking bathroom. I checked out how my fucking wings are looking. My lats are getting vicious. Right. It doesn't matter, dude. We're cool about it now. Like, I can tell you these things.
Yeah, I mean, I'm starting to understand more because when I first started.
It's a stretch and a flex.
I don't understand. Well, you fucked me up with that Romanian.
RDLs.
RDLs. All right, man. Yeah. So I don't understand what I'm supposed to be flexing.
Yeah, I never thought of stuff as far as like this is a 5 year into it exercise, especially since I see retarded chicks doing it all day long.
Yeah, so then I'm trying to find videos that will teach you how to activate your hamstring.
You got into like my sixth grade porn loop of like borderline shit on YouTube.
Yeah, thick fit.
Yes. Yeah. It's fucking insane.
But yeah, I never like I was doing those flies today. Yes. And I didn't understand until today. So I've been doing it for a month and I just figured out today what I'm supposed to be flexing.
Yes.
So you got to deal with me on the learning curve.
I mean, yeah, there's been multiple people who said you've gotten more jack. So like, I don't know what other evidence you need.
I'm not trying to get big. I'm trying to heal, bro.
I understand, you know what but I mean? With that, you're going to grow muscle.
Yeah.
And then are you potentially my swole mate? I don't want to rush into things. No, it's whatever. This is.
Well, I don't like failure on those dumbbells. That shit's fucking tough.
That's scary.
At the end, yeah.
You also look like an absolute psychopath just letting loose 40s onto the ground because they'll like bounce up and hit someone. You have like 80s that kind of like bounce once. You have 40s, they like might ricochet.
I was like sitting there like, I need help.
Yeah, you would look like the biggest cocksucker if you hit someone with a shin shot on 40s. Incline bench, just letting it all, leaving it all.
Whatever, today wasn't as strong as I was before, but I had better form today.
That's all it's about. Yeah. But dude.
You fucked me up though with this dumb shit about the flat earth, and then I got into
don't
the
do that. What? It's not dumb.
Well, I in my mind I'm like, all right, I'm gonna start checking more shit out.
It leads to psychosis.
I'm
getting to the bottom of all this shit leads to like, what the fuck even is all this?
I wanted to get in more like that's in the weeds, we'll say.
Yeah.
I wanted to get more into like stuff
civilization.
In the real world. You know what I mean? But no, fucking I had to get into cave systems. I had no idea.
Like,
what the fuck is going on with Mammoth Cave?
I'm 100% with you. You saw me in real time. I'm sitting there like, can't get rid of the dirt. Someone would see the dirt. Huge piles. So just nothing but huge piles everywhere. And
well,
then
Stephen Greer, I got hit with too much shit because this is going to be terrible to try to follow. But it was like Stephen Greer sitting there telling me there's a 1,300 square mile deep underground military base.
Yeah.
And you're telling me that they're already there. So then
trust what he says because he's jacked.
Then I look into this shit, and fucking, there's a thing that they call the big room.
Yes.
And I think it's like Carlsberg Cavern or something like that. I can't remember the name of it. Some kind of cavern. It's a tourist thing you can go to. It's 4,000 feet long, 600 feet wide, 250 feet tall. You can fit 6 football fields in there. Bro.
That's the ones they let you go to.
Yeah, for real. The Smithsonian. So then I got into the Smithsonian.
It's the best YouTube hole you can possibly get into because those dudes must make money off those because it's all. I'm pretty sure it's fair play. If you're talking about like caves and like Smithsonian shutting shit down, it's like you're not getting demonetized.
Yeah, but then I get into the Smithsonian and all the stuff that they've done over the years of hiding the giant skeletons. They try to say this is a hoax, but then this.
You're talking about the Hopi Indian. Site in the Grand Canyon.
Yeah, man. So you're pretty much following the same trajectory that I followed. Then I start looking into the Indians.
Yes.
And back at the end of the Indian Wars, there was like an attack by the fake news media. Dude, first of all of those articles about the Smithsonian when they're saying like, looking up 1909, late 19th century, early 20th century news.
Yes.
Complete bullshit. Literally,
I was just listening to something. I was like,
fake.
Dude, if it's written down, 98% of stuff that's written down just lies.
All of it's fake.
Mike Mentzer was saying that.
Yeah, so I'm sitting there, and I'm like, dude, the Indians, like, you know, everyone said Hopi have all this knowledge. They said that in the Grand Canyon, there was a city where they have all that Egyptian shit.
So the thing that fucked me up was...
So you're like fucking with my head. Like now I'm lost. I'm gone. Yeah. I was reading
fucking... This is the old world. That's what people don't want you to know. Bro, America is the old world.
I have books on like how they did 9/11. I'm trying to get into that shit. And fucking... then I'm sitting there reading about the Hopi. And then they say that all this shit was already there.
Yes.
When they came.
There's Buddhist statues of idols that are already there. Yes. That's fucking insane.
So... Then they said that these people were giants.
9 foot mummified like tomb statues.
The Smithsonian's funded from England. Smithsonian comes from a British dude.
Yeah.
Then I'm back in England. England has fucking giants. England's the land of giants. This is the fucking Gog Magog. We're going into Glastonbury, the burial of King Arthur. King Arthur was fucking 9
What's
feet
Gog
tall.
Gog Magog?
God, that's fucking...
Would you like to know?
Too much shit, dude.
King Arthur
up.
Was 9 feet tall, allegedly?
I mean, bro, you never know what's a hoax.
Sure.
So the second they dig up one of these giants, they say it's a hoax.
Yeah.
Allegedly, there's a picture of the queen standing there staring at one of these giant things. The royal family took the remains and they moved them. So they moved it to like another place.
Yeah,
like a chapel. Like they did have reverence for this giant body. And this shit goes back to like the 1400s, the 1100s. They were digging up, there's records in England of them digging up 14 foot giants, 9 foot giants.
Level with me here. If you're a dinosaur, I would believe it, right?
Okay.
You're like, oh, fucking velociraptor. And then now the dinosaur guys are just like, that's a chicken now. Could it be that maybe there was a big ass dinosaur that kind of resembled a human that looked like us, and now we're the chickens of them?
Mayhaps.
Good fucking thing.
They do say that there's like 36 foot giants. I have no idea. They said that there's skulls that are so big you could put your fist through it.
That's fucking insane.
You could put your fist through the eye hole.
Yeah.
They have multiple rows of teeth. They had they were breeding for like large pituitary diseases.
Yeah.
We would call them diseases.
I mean, it sounds like it was like an alien experiment that went awry. They had to fucking just firebomb them with comets.
Well, people think that they were the old world. So the old world was this land of giants that they could control the weather and they had psychic abilities.
Churches would make a lot more sense.
Well,
you walk into one of those bastards like, Jesus Christ.
I think it's Albion and Albina were the founders of England, something like that. They were giants. I don't know. I didn't have time for all this shit. I got into checking out the Indian Wars. So, like, there was Custer and the Indian Wars.
Damn, fucking Salt Rock Land flickered when you brought up the Indian Wars. We're probably we have to recognize that we are on stolen land.
They started talking about, so I'm sitting there, like, Indians claim to know all this shit.
Yeah.
But they got rocked. So while they were really, after they got rocked to the point of, like, it's over.
Yeah.
There was this dude, Wovoka, and him and his dad were boys with, like, this guy that had a prophecy saying, don't worry. The white man will be fucking expelled out of here. And it was like an Armageddon type thing for the Indians. And they created this like weird little cult where they were doing this thing called the ghost dance. And the ghost dance was like,
all right, now you're scaring me.
I'm assuming like going to bring on the end of the white man, help from their ancestors.
Yeah.
And they started wearing these shirts. I can't remember what they're called. I did write it down. They started rocking this shit like eagle feathers,
sweet
claws, you know?
Yeah.
And, they call it ghost shirts. And they thought it
makes
would
sense.
They thought if they wore these ghost shirts that it would protect them from bullets.
And so they got casinos.
Oh. Yeah. So I was like, all right, Indian dudes are retarded. Fuck this.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not listening to any of this shit anymore. And but what was interesting was the mainstream media of the time, the New York Times and all this stuff.
They've been around for a long time.
No one cared.
Why don't they have to fucking say sorry for anything? They're spewing lies about all this shit, especially Indians.
Like, so,
I feel sorry for being white.
They had this kid with Voca, his dad died, and he got raised by whites. So he ended up getting a white name, I think like James Wilson or
He's
something
like Colin Kaepernick of Indians.
Pretty much. And then they taught him Christianity and the Book of Revelation. So the combination of him knowing like the Indian mysticism.
Yeah.
And then the Christian Messiah stuff, he was like, I'm fucking Wovoka. Don't worry about it. I'm going to bring you guys to the next world.
And this is early 1900s?
This is late 1900s, okay. Or late 1800s. So anyway, this is not a big deal. They're doing the ghost dances, and they think they have bulletproof shirts on.
Yeah.
This isn't, like, a threat, right? The news is, like, set, like the news is just trying to hype shit up, being like, you got to watch out for these guys. They're doing this ghost dance.
Russia has nuclear capabilities.
They're going to summon the end of the end of us here. And all
Hopi Indians have weapons of mass destruction.
And, dude, the guy from Wizard of Oz, Frank Baum, wrote a thing saying, like, to the news, being like, dude, chill. Like, they're just dancing. And he wasn't some kind of liberal of the day. He he wanted the extermination of the Native Americans. But he was like, guys, this is fake. Like,
yeah, you're liars.
You're liars. But it got everybody up in a frenzy. Sitting Bull, he's like one of the old
OGs.
Indian generals. Actually, allegedly, he was kind of a pussy and just had everybody else fight for him, hence the sitting. But he fucking...
Did they have fucked up nicknames?
Yeah, they all do. Then, but what happened was... Wounded Knee happened, where the media got all the whites into a frenzy. The military was like, yeah, we're going to outlaw the ghost dance. You can't be doing this dance.
Damn, it's like, and when they stopped doing Irish step dance in fucking Ireland.
Exactly. And they rounded up like a couple hundred fucking women and children, and dude, they had their ghost shirts on. They were like, fuck you.
Dude.
Like,
why?
This is like, there's...
Was
like,
it to take the land?
I mean, all of this was to take the land.
Yeah, I mean, they got rez, though.
But, yeah, the fucking Wounded Knee was like a massacre. What and it was all, like, drummed up hysteria from...
By lame shit. Because
the Black Hill Wars were over. Like, they lost. The Sioux, the Lakota, like, they were done.
Yeah, that was a great time in grade school, learning about all that shit.
Yeah, it was cool, man. I got into that, and I was fucking... That saved me from the caves. This caves freaked me out, going down in those depths.
Dude, it's... Another, like, everyone, like, that's why I fucking laugh at all. Dudes are like, I wish you understood physics. It's like, cunt, go into a cave that never ends. How are you going to figure out anything if you don't even know what the fuck we're on?
They say shit real nonchalant. Like, Mammoth Cave in Kentucky, which I'd love to go to, they just found 8 more miles of it. Brother, step out the door.
Walk 8 miles.
Tell me how you just found that underground and that's not a huge fucking deal.
That's like, that's why I think that, like, all of, like,
if it doesn't end, what if it doesn't end?
Yeah, that's what I don't understand. Like, you have all this money, you can go to fucking space, go to all the shit, map out the tunnels that are in here. You're digging a hole forever into the earth, just melting bits. Go into these tunnels and figure out what the fuck's in there. Because, like, the thing that pissed me off with the flat earth stuff is the people are like, oh, well, 4,000 feet down, it's magma. Dude, we only went fucking 9 miles.
There should eventually be a face-off between, like, all the Neil deGrasses, all the science guys against, like, some of the more terrifying flat earthers are at 10th planet.
Yes. Yes, like, Eddie Bravo's weaponized fucking guys dudes. And they can beat you up.
These guys are aggressive flat earthers, man, and they just want to see the curve.
Well, like...
They want to know how, like, I read a thing. I actually should go get it. I read a paragraph that was, like, a legit dude questioning evolution.
Dude, it doesn't make fucking sense.
Yeah.
But, like, that's what I understand. All those dudes will sit there and laugh and be like, oh, well, physics this, gravity that.
The guy was talking about, there's a famous thing saying, if you got, just about randomness and stuff, if you got all the monkeys to jump on typewriters, eventually they would come up with, like, an award-winning book. Like a
Shakespeare
book.
Fucking.
Right? Okay, yeah. It might actually be Shakespeare fucking. This dude's saying, like, the odds of that happening are, like, none.
Yeah.
They're just literally going to... They're not going to put together a book. They might get a couple words.
Maybe.
You know what I mean?
You ever see their feet?
But to think that, like, random evolution led to this is insanity.
It doesn't make sense, and that's what pisses me off, because, like, oh, well, after the Big Bang, it's like, your whole shit is based on a lie. Therefore... Much like COVID, I can't fucking believe anything you say after that. Your whole thing is like, oh, it exploded. Like, they sit there and laugh at people like, oh, this guy's actually talking about being a Catholic. This guy, like, believes in God. It's like, dude, your shit is more ridiculous than that.
Yeah, right.
Because you think that you know how this all started. You're out of your fucking mind. Like, you are delusional if you think you have the answer to how this started and that we came from germs to this. Okay, dude.
Yeah, that was actually what the guy says in the book. It says, like, it's insane to think that amoeba...
Anyone who thinks they know what's going on is a fucking idiot.
Yeah, like, we would go from amoebas to this in, like, such a short period of time.
Very fast. Yeah. Like, this is insanity.
Yeah, that fucked me up. Then I got into that the Earth is growing conspiracy, which I very much.
I started listening to that. I'm too stupid for that, bro.
I enjoy that stuff, dude. Like, Pangea's a lie.
What?
Pangea.
Why, though?
Because the world's axis would have had to move because the land masses were all on one side.
True.
So, like, this dude's, like, sitting there going, like, dude, Pangea's a lie. The Earth was smaller. The Earth is growing, and that's what, like, the oceans are. The oceans are the Earth growing.
I wonder how, I mean.
Like, it starts out as, like, a landmass, just like you would see, like.
A rock.
Yeah, a rock. And then as it's expanding, so we don't know what the middle
is. It's like leaving something in the dark and watching mold grow on it.
Bro, what if the middle is, like, the, what if the beginning. Earth, A, the Earth might be alive, first of all.
I mean, dude, obviously, you know that.
Yeah, it might be growing just like we grow.
It gave birth to us. Obviously, the Earth is alive.
Whatever.
Damn, that fucking makes a lot of sense.
It's cool to watch because he has the tectonic plates going all together. Whereas they don't have that on Pangea. They make it like they make it go together, but it's on one side of the Earth, and then there's this giant ocean.
Yeah, it doesn't make any
fucking
sense. The guy
says it doesn't make any sense. And if you reverse the plates, you just end up, it makes a lot more sense the whole world was smaller. And he says it's happened like very quickly in the last like 750 million years.
That dude, that could easily happen. Like, now, I just like theories, dude. So I'm not.
Either, that's what I'm saying. This is, you got me into theory land. I wanted to stay in the fact land. No. Nah. You know, I wanted to get into the facts, bro.
I just fucking, I never knew that. I didn't like spurg on you about the caves. The ones that are in China make no sense because they're down in lakes and they drain the lake because they saw little like statues of things. Yeah, yeah. All the way to the bottom lakes, and then there's just miles of fucking caves that are, they don't know where they go to.
Well, one of my new goals is to try to find a place, try to find some land that I could buy with a cave on it.
That would be, I don't know how you would find
it. I don't
even
know how you go about that.
Yeah, but dude, it was up until Sunday when we were chilling here. I was always thinking about how they built those fuckers. It makes complete sense. Those dudes find cave systems if you want to make a deep underground military base. And then they just start shaving it out, making it nice and spherical, putting fucking gunite all over the walls, concrete and everything, rebarring the tits off of it.
Yeah, there's cave houses that you can buy. There's people that have outfitted caves as houses.
Yeah, I mean, this seems like it makes the most sense. And that's where I start thinking about, like, the people that could potentially be in there. Because you never get to the end of any of these fucking caves. They that's where people are saying Ike's a fucking psycho. So, dude, you easily could have, like, if you didn't have any sunlight and the whole time you evolved to live under fucking ground, just like we evolved.
This is the time machine, dude.
What?
It's the book, The Time Machine.
Are you serious?
And, H.G. Wells, all those guys, they were plugged in. All those guys were plugged into the Royal Society.
Yes.
You know, like Darwin. They were planning out millions of years of hyper-evolution. They were going to, like, eugenics us into superhumans.
Really?
Yeah. They wanted a separate world, bro.
Yeah, it's just, it's odd when you do shit like smoke DMT and stuff, and it's nothing but tunnels and nothing but, like, reptilian-looking people that you get to the end of the tunnel and there's a reptile there.
I don't know about that. I didn't see that, but
I'm just saying, like, some people do. They see serpents and all this stuff. Like, there's something up with tunnels, and at the end of the day, I just think we're the outside dogs, and it goes in, if you want to call it the Shangri-La or whatever the fuck that place
Shambhala.
Is. Shambhala. I believe in that 100%.
Yeah.
If you were getting rocked by comets when this thing had no atmosphere.
Well, that's what the Hopis were saying, that they would go into this cave structure. They said that the people of old used the cave system for protection in times of, like.
Makes complete sense,
you
dude.
Know, when space is chucking shit at you.
It doesn't make any sense that those dudes are just sitting out there in the desert with no grub, no shelter, and like, oh, the dark skin is why they can sit out there. It's like, dude, the sun's still going to fuck you up if you're out in the fucking desert.
You're saying the red man didn't adapt?
I'm saying the red man could have adapted, but they definitely had some like cave systems that they're not going to fucking tell you about.
Yeah.
It could literally be a whole nother society going on, and like the reptilian elite make complete sense when you go down that fucking rabbit hole of looking at shit.
Yeah, it was very weird when I saw that they defended the giants in England. So the English have, like, a whole world. Like, they got rocked by the same, like, New World Order when they brought in the new royals.
Do you know, like, what their bag was before?
Their
like,
bag was, like, we come from giant. This is the land of giants.
Like, fucking Celts and shit
like
that?
I can't say it because it's, like, It's some kind of Gaelic or some shit. Some kind of Irish, but it's like Tuathlan Danann or something. It's like a whole, it's a whole tribe of giants. And they were like the lords. And they lived in like the mountains. And they claim that they control the weather. And they claim that if you go to disturb their graves now, there will be lightning strikes.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, I'm into that kind of shit.
I'm into it too. It's cool stuff.
It honestly got it. Like, for some reason, they're on like a war to just make you feel like you're insignificant. You bring nothing to the table. You'll die, and none of this shit will matter, all because science fucking says so.
Yeah, they did change the history in Wales. So in Wales, they like totally believed when you grew up, you got taught that King Arthur was real.
Yeah.
Came here from like Rome, whatever, Brutus or Maximus or whatever the fuck. All this shit was real. And then out of nowhere, they brought in the new horseman education system that we got, and they wiped all that shit out. And they were like, nope, you're not doing that anymore. That was a myth. So it used to be history, but then it was myth. But then you also have to think, was everybody retarded like the Hopis throwing on ghost shirts? So that's why I just want to clap my hands and go, it doesn't matter. I don't care if we're on a plane. I don't care if we're on a ball. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's what like...
It doesn't phase me at all, man.
I agree, and it's just like... All you have to do is fucking live your life, but you have to know that, like, maybe the dudes who are on TV and there's tons of money behind them talking aren't telling the truth. Like, the dude, your boy, your fucking top dog, Hotez.
Oh, my top dog?
I'm just saying.
He's a pussy, dude.
You liked him.
I liked Hotez.
Yes. Was Hotez the one that when
all I said that I liked about Hotez was he was fighting the fucking tire diseases in poor neighborhoods because I was suffering from that. Do you remember when I had swarms of mosquitoes in the south?
Dude, it was so disgusting.
I had people with dump tires.
I cleaned the driveway.
Yeah, but I'm saying like that kind of shit. That's the only thing I liked hearing. But that dude's out there trying to get. There's people in America that suffer from West Nile because of tires in urban areas.
Dude, that is fucked.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, like,
that's real.
You get
stupid
out south. There's like
people.
Yeah, I mean it's fucked up.
Yeah, is Hotez the guy that was on Rogan right before COVID happened, or is that a different guy?
No, it was during, I think it was during COVID.
Who was the dude who went on Rogan? He seemed like to be more of a chat.
Another guy.
That's the other dude who was saying like COVID's going to be real fucking bad.
He was the guy that was saying that there was going to be like 2 million dead or something. I can't remember his name.
Like Uncle Cliff saying that. There was going to be a billion people dead of the vaccine.
Exactly, exactly.
Who knows, the numbers could be fucking doctored. But that, I mean, this shit's pumping me up. Like,
you're getting into a good timeline now. They're starting another cycle of all the stuff that you enjoy.
Well,
Trump's getting hit with the Espionage Act.
If you listen to Jones, me and him are on the same line of thinking that, like, maybe there's a great awakening coming. Think 10 years ago, the amount of people you could chuck Flat Earth out to, and they would be like, dude, you're fucking out of control. Now, like, you can at least exist without being completely excommunicated from all serious conversations. If you're just like, dude, I think it's a ball is what it is, or I think it's flat.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I'm trying to figure out if this... I'm like looking at stuff right now. Like in my mind, I'm thinking there must have been a cycle of this shit before. And yeah. I get into all that stuff about how there's like different types of conspiracy theories where it's like the enemy within, the enemy from above.
Yeah.
And I'm wondering if there's a great awakening thing that has happened before. Because that ghost dance stuff was like that. I was reading about the ghost dance.
They were just saying, trust the plan.
And it was like, and I was like, well, I'm right here. It's hopium. No offense to the Hopis. This is more of a Lakota thing. But that's what they were doing. Like it was pure hopium. And they were like, don't worry. These shirts protect you from bullets.
Did anyone get shot?
It was a massacre. It's called Wounded Knee.
They must have made him wrong.
It was
bro.
Like the very... So they ended...
Were they actually shot or were they stabbed?
Dude, they ended... The Indian Wars ended, I think, in like 1877. And then this shit happened in like 1890. So they were like... The hope...
This is just dunking on them years later.
It went on for like three... This whole conspiracy or whatever the fuck you want to call it of like the ghost dance of like we're going to wipe out the whites just by dancing. And it was crazy. It was like... Dance for so they want he wanted them for like 6 weeks to dance 5 days a week and then everyone communally bathed in the river. It was like a whole thing they were doing. It was like a cult.
Dude, imagine rolling up on that as a whitey and you just see those guys dancing. Someone's like, "You want me to shoot him?" It's like, "Yeah, fire one off." Like,
yeah,
getting hit with a musket must have sucked. Them was that musket land?
Oh yeah. Well, no, the North. So they would have had real bullets.
They had a rifle, but they had definitely a rifle. Were they like ammo or were they circles?
The circles were done. The minute balls were done.
Oh, so they were getting hit with
they
real
were getting
bullets?
Hit with the
Maybe they were fucking immune to minute balls.
They
bro.
Were getting hit with the new Union Army's fucking rifles.
That was, I mean.
They rounded up women and children and fucking just shot them.
Oh,
like hundreds. Yeah.
Just because they stirred it up.
But the media stirred it up, but then Sitting Bull was like, yeah, I'm down with the ghost dance. And then when all the whites knew who Sitting Bull was.
Dude, he's an asset. He's a fucking asset.
He
might
have been an asset of the day.
100%.
He might have been an asset because he was actually a performer. He was in Hollywood doing.
Sitting Bull, we're making casinos.
He was doing.
Let us kill 100 of these fuckers.
He was doing the road shows. So this was like after he was doing the Wild West.
Oh, okay. Road yeah, shows yeah.
With Buffalo Bill and shit. But then he was like, no, I'm down with the ghost dance. And then when he said it, all the newspapers were like
Jamie Foxx getting the vaccine.
Exactly. And then they fucking rounded him up. But like all this stuff, the news is crazy. Like we are living in a better time. You know, everyone cries about censorship and shit.
Oh yeah.
I was checking out that Espionage Act stuff. And during World War I, it was so bad. They evacuated Germans from Washington, D.C.
Wait, what?
They were like, no.
Oh, all, you can't be trusted?
All you guys can't be trusted. So they like kicked just German folks.
Out
folks.
Of D.C.?
They kicked them out of D.C. There was a German filmmaker that made a movie that was like about the American Revolution, but it painted the British in a bad light. It showed British massacres, and they fucking arrested them because the British were our allies in World War I. So like that, and that they used the Espionage Act to arrest a filmmaker, a German filmmaker.
So you're pretty much saying, quit, you're crying. That's fucking
these German
nuts.
Filmmakers just have to calm down, dude.
True, honestly, they really do. I guess it is a little better now than it was back then because, like, dude, you couldn't even get any info. Like you're just like fully fucking retarded. I mean,
but that was like a lot. Like before this, before the Civil War and stuff, you were more free.
Yeah.
It was like some shit came when they came in, the Cecil Rhodes team, when they came into America and they started pulling off the Lusitania and World War I.
Sinking the USS Liberty.
Yeah. This is when those boys came in here, it was like, then we're getting the Espionage Act. And none of that shit is fucking legal if you look at the Constitution.
Ooh. So you're
I'm not a lawyer, but I'm just saying this.
You're telling me that maybe the Civil War was drummed up by the MSM?
Hey, man. They drummed up a fucking Wounded Knee massacre. I don't think they apologized ever for it.
True. I mean, they do now.
Mark Twain said it was bullshit.
What do you mean?
When this shit was going on, those guys were alive. These authors were alive, and they're like, dude, why are you guys hyping this up? Because they're reading it going, this is absolute fucking, it's like the National Enquirer stuff.
Yeah, true. Fuck. I never even thought of news being that, like, brutal back then.
That's what I'm saying. Like, this time
weren't
period,
they, like, called muckrakers and shit?
When you see this
is
time
that, like,
period,
election stuff?
Yeah. When you see this, when you see this shit.
That'll take off.
When you see the screenshots in the memes of, like,
the old
giants
papers.
Found in 1909 in the desert, it's literally, like, right alongside all the other fake shit that they were writing.
Oh, really?
You know what I mean? Like, so,
I get what you're saying.
Yeah. Like, all the news was fake, so. Then the Smithsonian comes out. The guy that ran the Smithsonian from, like, 1900 to 1940, he was like, dude, giants are bullshit. Stop. For 40 fucking years. And this guy was a nut.
And the dude who ran the Smithsonian?
Yeah. The Smithsonian's been covering up
where
a ton
is
of
it?
Shit. D.C.
D.C.?
Yeah.
That's what, like,
it's some weird dude who was a bastard child of a British lord who died in Genoa, Italy.
Dude, what?
His name's Smithson.
First name Smithson?
His last name.
Oh, okay. I was going to say, someone's fucking.
But we're going back to, like, earls and stuff, and the right. Dude was educated in, like, some college in Oxford. So, like, we're going back to, like, the Royal Academy shit of guys that would have come. That money somehow is funding an institute that's, like, going to tell you that the earth. The mounds, the serpent mound, wasn't built by giants. The mound builders were just, the mounds were just here.
Yeah, that, and
you know what I mean? Like,
the fact that they, like, line up with a star perfectly is fucking ridiculous.
I'm just saying the same guys that are, like, the people that are also covering up the giants in England.
Yeah.
At the same time are like, oh, we got to go to America and fund all that, too.
That's
very suspicious.
Well, that's what I'm saying, where it's like.
And they don't like to have these myths going around.
Dude, because it brings power. Like, you get power when you're like, oh, I come from what? Oh, this is fucking sick. You feel a lot better, like, about yourself. And
that's what these people are complaining about. The Arthurian myths were in the bones of the British.
Yes.
And then they were just like, nope, That was fake.
No, you're actually a fucking germ, dude. That's what they want you to think. Or you could be part of someone, obviously, who built this. Because it started from something. So you are in touch with the thing that made this.
Honestly,
that should pump you
the fuck
up.
All of this shit is, even you trying to figure it out is retarded.
Oh, yeah, it's insane.
Because it's just, dude, just exist.
The only, dude, every time I think about it, because I was talking to someone about it the other day, and I was like, dude, like, I don't even know.
Imagine spending your whole life trying to figure out how, where we came from.
And dude, you go insane. You can't, you go, what, when this happens, you go home, you lay down on the couch and you close your eyes until you get hungry. You open them, you eat ground beef and rice. You go think.
I'm telling you, lifting weights makes me dumb and sleepy. I'm telling you.
You become a goon, dude.
I'm telling you right now. I can barely string thoughts together.
I had to stop going to the gym. I was so fucked up in the head for a while. I was looking at everyone like, you're all going to die. Why is this going on? Who the fuck started this? All I had was looking straight ahead at a road and this. I couldn't even bring myself to the gym.
It's gotta be wild if you go to like 10th planet and they're just all like, yeah, dude, fuck it. It's a plane. Let's wrestle.
I mean, I think you should be able to hold down whatever things you want. It is weird that now, like, with the new election coming up and stuff, they're just like, dude, you can question the election. Like, there are, something is going to fucking happen. The fact that they're just, like, kind of taking all the fucking cuffs off everyone is like, yeah, you can talk about whatever you want.
Well, who's saying you can now?
Oh, it's okay to, like, talk about election.
We can let it rip?
Oh, yeah. You can talk about, you can talk about whatever you want. YouTube's not going to censor anymore, I think. I'm not a YouTube head.
I know they
head.
Just pulled off, what do you call it? They just took a Peterson and RFK Jr. off.
For what?
They just did like a thing and they took it off. I have no idea why.
Dude, fucking, I think Tate just got charged too.
Fuck, man. So much going on and all I care about is fucking King Arthur and the fairy tales.
The Matrix is literally trying to end this fucking man. I saw it on my way here. I was like, damn, if he gets hit with human trafficking charges, that's tough.
Yeah.
Because they're, I mean, I'm not a part of Hustlers U or anything like that.
What's his top tier?
With the War Room?
The War Room.
$10,000. Yeah. I mean, we didn't come up with that idea together. He makes a lot of fucking sense. The only thing I don't like about him is his fucking dad being in the CIA. And then, like, I just get real confused when dudes
that's
who
the
just.
The only thing you don't like?
Yeah. What else would I like about him? What the heck, dude? Dude, you're being real weird. The, just his dad being in the CIA and then him getting this much fame for nothing. Because we were laughing at that Tate stuff forever ago.
Oh, yeah.
When he's sitting there talking about water.
That's what I'm saying. You were making fun of him for fucking a year.
I loved him. I thought the fucking videos were hilarious. And then out of nowhere, they're just like, dude, you're up. It's almost like when you were talking about the Bonesman. Like, this dude just got tapped. And like, oh, yeah, you're up. Because those videos could have just stayed 20,000 views, nothing, no big deal, just fucking around.
Well, yeah, I mean, it's pretty crazy. I don't know. I know that during that Peterson RFK thing, he told a story about how he did a 3-week long interview with Jake Tapper.
Who?
RFK Jr. And it was all.
Oh, Jake Tapper went to him. I thought you meant like fucking RFK interviewed Jake Tapper for some reason.
I think Jake Tapper went to RFK Jr.'s house for like 3 weeks.
Dude.
And they did like an intensive, because like RFK Jr. was boys with Roger Ailes. So Roger Ailes ran Fox News.
Yeah.
Rupert Murdoch owns it though. So Roger Ailes is the dude. Everyone thought he was like a bad actor.
Is he like the dude who's allegedly secession?
Like, he's the guy that like turned Fox into like what it is today.
Okay.
Right? So fucking RFK Jr. does this like 3-week thing and it was going to be about, I think it was going to be about like mercury and the vaccines and stuff.
Tapper was doing this shit.
So they did this thing. They put it together. They worked on it for 3 weeks. Then Roger Ailes tells RFK Jr. it's done. Jake Tapper says it's never happened to him his entire life, and he's pissed off. Jake Tapper never talked to RFK Jr. again.
Are you fucking kidding me?
He's never talked to him again.
Tapper's like the high pitch, right?
So Roger Ailes tells him that, dude, you can, if you talk about this stuff, if one of my anchors lets you talk about this, I have to fire them. And he's like, Rupert will call me. Because all of the funding, 75%.
All fucking Big Pharma.
75% of the commercials are Big Pharma.
Yeah.
So all their revenue is coming from that. So Murdoch will call Ailes and be like, fire that person. Get rid of fucking RFK. So Jake Tapper's never talked to him since.
When was this?
I don't know. Maybe in like, you know.
Way 10, back?
Maybe like 2015, something like that.
Holy fuck, bro.
Do you remember when it was like coming out? It was like Vaxxed? Remember the movie Vaxxed?
Yes.
And De Niro?
Robert De Niro was supposed to have it at Tribeca Film Fest.
So all I'm saying is.
That fucking fag.
All I'm saying is, it's kind of weird. Like, RFK Jr., when he was a young kid, when he was like 19, he spent like, I think it was like 7 weeks or some shit with Roger Ailes in a tent in Africa. Like, RFK Jr. grew up. He's an elite.
Yes.
So he's like going on fucking weird shit like that. Doing like environmental work, whatever the fuck he's into, because he's a Kennedy.
What the
fuck? So Roger Ailes, like, so they go way back. So they, like, he was friends with him when he was such a young kid.
Yeah.
That Roger Ailes was like, he would put RFK Jr. on to talk about the environment whenever he wanted.
Obviously.
And then when it got into the vaccine stuff, so like his progression is like environmental work, mercury in the rivers, like runoff into the rivers. Then it's like mercury in the vaccines. And like mercury is more deadly than like anything radioactive.
Dude, I remember being terrified of thermometers.
Yeah, like mercury is like the most deadly fucking.
Thermometers.
Yeah, mercury is like the most deadly. It's like deadlier than lead.
Oh.
So
it looks crazy.
Yeah, so it's just what I think is, like, they get some shit on you. It's like, if you're Jake Tapper.
Have to.
If you're Jake Tapper, if you're fucking Robert De Niro, there's forces at play that have your compromised manila folder.
Dude.
Your dossier.
Thought about it the other day. Like, literally, anytime you're out and you get drunk, it takes one blackout. It would be worth it for someone to watch you every time you went out to finally catch you blacked out and just be like, come here.
Yeah.
And then you're in pictures with 13-year-olds. You're fucked.
Yeah, well.
I'm going to stop drinking.
Tapper never talked to him again, which is fucking weird.
That's
the weird part.
Of RFK.
No, that's the weird part of Tapper. Like, that's the weird part of all this stuff is how they flip and then they never go back. Like, De Niro was like into this.
Oh, yeah.
And then he never went back.
And got like, very gay with Trump.
And he had compromising shit from the 90s.
True. What was the movie?
Ronin,
yeah. That's why, like, I love RFK, what's going on with him right now. But it's like when you fucking meet a chick and you're just like, this is too perfect. Something is fucked up here.
Yeah, right.
Something has to fucking go wrong. I remember myself 2020. I was welding a dumpster down in Chester. It got announced Biden won the presidency. I literally fucking put everything down. I was like, I'm never voting again. I'm never falling for it. It does not fucking matter. I'm done with this shit.
Most of the things you get told are a lie, dude. It is what it is.
I mean,
we were talking about the Unabomber, and I was getting into all that shit. And fucking, you know that book, Walden by Thoreau?
Negative. It's Louis, like, Thoreau?
No, but that guy's documentary on Scientology rules.
Obviously.
Fucking.
Who the fuck is Thoreau?
Thoreau wrote this book, Walden.
You might be learning too much stuff.
Where you can't. This is going to be bad. Because I can't. I have to work. Give me this much time.
You're weaponized.
So.
There's a line in The Wire about giving you guys books.
This is why they didn't let him learn how to read.
Yeah.
Like, Walden fucking is fake. Walden's his book, like, I think you kind of have to read it in college or something.
Yeah.
It's all about some neat that goes out and lives in the woods and claims that he, like, lived in the woods for 2 years and, like, learned so much about himself or whatever. This, like, crazy life.
So it's the same shit with, like, fucking sense depth tanks. It's like, you wind up just sitting there, like,
well,
it's weird.
So he writes his book. He claims that he lives out in, like, the wilderness for 2 years by a lake and by his lonesome. And a year into it, he's already giving speeches about what he's up to. Dude, every weekend, his mom and his sister
are Bear Grylls
bringing him food.
Yeah.
He can walk to town. He lived this thing.
I mean, this is a hipster.
This thing in the wilderness, this thing in the wilderness is like a mile from a road. It's 2 miles from his mom's house, and it's like on a road. It's on like a highway. And he could walk into town. He would walk into town on the weekends. So he was just doing it 5 days a week, and
this is the first hipster.
He was going into fucking
forest. All of a sudden, got nice.
He was raiding his mom's house for pies and stuff.
As you do when you're in the woods rummaging.
Crazy, man.
What the, like?
So that's a lie. So this whole thing, because they would compare the Unabomber to fucking, they compared Ted Kaczynski to living like a Thoreau's life, like this thing. It's like, dude, no way. Ted was real.
I don't understand how, like, they're, I don't know. I've never seen anything since, but they're saying he might have killed himself. It makes no sense that dude went that long and then was like, you know what, fucking, I'm pulling the trigger.
You never know.
I mean, dude.
I don't know how you can kill yourself in prison, but I've never been to prison.
I mean, Jeffrey Epstein did.
Yeah.
Oh, well. Yeah, I'd fucking, I think I'm just completely out, and the only thing we can do, at this point, the only thing you can do is make your body better and try to be fucking nice to everyone, because anything you read, it's, the only thing I've came down to is, you read this shit, and you start, you just, you get into like four whys, and on like the fourth or fifth why, everything starts falling apart. You start looking into it, and then you start thinking about how everything got here, and it's just a speed wobble.
And you're just sitting there, and you're like, so there's these two towers, and somehow just through the gravitational force, they're throwing steel beams 500 feet away.
It threw steel beams 500 feet away.
And regular people will be like, oh, that makes sense. But they can't really understand what it would take to throw a steel I-beam 500 feet, dude.
Dude, that's long as fuck.
Yeah, dude. A football field's 300 feet.
Yeah, but like, dude,
the it pulverized concrete.
Yeah.
Gravity can't pulverize concrete.
It doesn't make a lot of sense.
Create a dust cloud.
It does not make a lot of sense. I mean, this all is that asbestos kind of would.
That all I'm saying is that's the kind of shit I have. These books that they're 800 page books. All right, man, you don't have to fucking paint today. Let's get down to the bottom of it. Then you hit me with caves. And I'm fucking gone. And then I'm like, oh no, I have to.
Sorry, now these are interesting.
Yeah, then I'm going back to the fairy tales.
Yes.
Then I'm just going back to the Grimm brothers. There's a fucking book.
But dude, maybe it's the people guiding us from above. Where you're like, I'm going to figure out how 9/11 happened, and then they're like, hey, cunt, you have to go to the end of the caves to figure it all out first. You got to start at the foundation and work your way up to 9/11.
Dude, so I was checking out the fairy tales, and like, I always thought it was just the Grimm brothers. Right,
I never knew dick about this until you told me. I thought all this stuff was just
Disney
normal
like,
shit.
Disney like takes these things, but I thought they were Grimm fairy tales, and they're not.
What?
There's a guy in France. I can't remember his name. It's like Charles Pinal or something. Most of the stories come from France and Sicily in the 1636.
Italians are saying that they're the ones who made them up.
Dude, in 1636, there's this dude. Giambastida Basile, right? And he has this book that goes around. It's like he collected oral traditions in 1630s, and he was called it the Tale of Tales. And they renamed it something like the Decameron or the Pentameron or something in America, because the actual name of it is Lo Conto de Le Conti. Yeah.
I'm cool with that.
Yeah, yeah. But it's cool. It's like, the real.
So the Grimm fairy tales aren't the Disney ones?
No, a lot of them come from these other stories. And they're all like, you know, I'm sure you've heard this shit before. Like, actually, Sleeping Beauty got raped.
No. I don't know shit about the Grimm fairy
tales. What they think it was.
Real
was,
sickos writing this shit.
They think it was like, we treat children like they're a separate fucking species at this point.
Yeah.
But back in the day, a kid would just be a small adult. That obviously lived in a house with you.
I dream of having a child just so I can talk to them normal their whole child life.
And they couldn't so these stories that you're hearing that are the fairy tales, they were probably like bar tales, like stories that you would tell, like a traveling bard would say, or like you would go to a bar and be drinking and some dude would tell
sitting
you.
Sitting around a campfire, like he's got a good one.
Yeah, like Goldilocks. You know Goldilocks?
Yep.
Goldilocks is actually just supposed to be some old beet roast.
Oh.
And the three bears in Goldilocks are just supposed to be drunk dudes at a bar.
Oh.
Whoa. And fucking, like, so Sleeping Beauty gets raped and has two kids while she's asleep. And then one of them bites her nipple trying to feed, and then she wakes up. Yeah, she wakes up, yeah.
That's Sleeping Beauty.
Well, then the king comes back because he's like, dude, I remember I fucking raped some chick back there. Let's see what's up. And he meets his family, and he's like, fuck.
I gotta kill that night.
And he's like, dude, fuck my queen. You're my queen. The Sleeping Beauty doesn't even know there's a queen. Doesn't even know this dude's the king.
She's a dumb bitch.
Then that queen finds out about it, and then she tries to make the king. The king's eating a meat pie, and he's like, and she's like, "That's yours. That's like your own meat or whatever, some shit like that. And he's like, yeah, damn, this is good.
Fuck right, it's
and
my pie.
She told the chef to cook the kids into the mince pies.
Oh, fuck.
You know, like, the Sleeping Beauty's drug. This isn't the Disney movie.
Holy fuck.
But these guys that collected these tales, like, this is what they were telling the kids when they were little back in the 1600s.
No wonder fucking George Washington became a surveyor at like 15, bro, hearing some scary
shit. Yeah, you
would
have had like a way more rugged lifestyle, like watching your dad basically like drunk rape your mom, shit like that. Like the abuse.
Everyone's
the
dumb as shit.
Everything's dirty. People are dying of disease like constantly.
Yeah, like, I mean, they would champ losing a son.
Oh, dude, many sons.
No better help in sight.
Your wife was always pregnant, too. These chicks were always pregnant, dude.
That would. All I think about when I think about back then is just what the fuck that smelled like.
Yeah, I think about
that
it.
Had to have reeked, dude.
Yeah, and they were all pervert. Like they were all the writers and shit were obsessed with sex.
Obviously.
And fucking Shakespeare was obsessed with sex. And I found out, you know, Romeo and Juliet.
Yeah.
You know that song where it's the baubles, and we were talking about the baubles.
The outlaw.
Yeah, not the. It's
The outlaws.
No, fucking
highwayman. Highwayman. Sorry.
And a bauble is actually a head on a stick, right? That, yes. Like, little girls would have. It's just a head.
Oh, like
this
a doll.
This is where we get bobbleheads.
Oh.
It's crazy.
Many a young maiden lost her baubles to my claim.
So, allegedly, in Romeo and Juliet, there's all these, like, innuendo jokes. There's all, in Shakespeare, there's all this innuendo stuff. And, like, a bauble would be like a dick, like a head with a stick. Yeah. You know what I mean? Yeah.
How the fuck did you get into all this?
You can't give me a day. This is literally one day of me chilling. This was the first day that I got done when I didn't have to work. I sat down and just fucking tried to get into stuff. But this is going to fuck our podcast up. This is going to fuck everything up.
But it is, you're like,
dude,
I could watch.
I got into art. I got into Goya. Because I haven't looked into this shit in
like
forever.
Like the beans?
Yeah, so Goya was this fucking, I love Goya.
Before we go anywhere.
Yeah, sorry, man. I should shut up.
No. Go you're on. Good. What you have to understand is, I could watch with my eyes taped open the same video 5 times and not be able to fucking regurgitate what the fuck happened there. Like, you've just done scratching your balls and reading.
Yeah, but I mean, reading's different.
Dude, when I read, I just lose the paragraph and I start thinking.
Yeah, but
I'm gone.
You just got to reverse it. That might also be bicameral mind shit, dude. You might have to learn how to speed read.
Dude, you know what I was doing that was fucking crazy the other night before we get into Goya? I fucking woke up and I was like, I'm going back to sleep. And I was asleep and I was trying to go back to sleep. And I was like, I'm going to start dreaming. And I kept moving my eyeballs, trying to go like up towards my brain. And I would see the flickering of a dream and then it would go back away because my eyeballs would go back down. Then I would raise them back up. Doesn't matter. Continue. Go ahead.
Dude, there might be a future where people like you could give people like me through stuff, something like Vision Pro.
Like that Black Mirror.
The experience of, fuck Black Mirror, dude. I tried to watch the Black, yeah, you do love that show.
So woke.
So
everything's woke now.
Yeah, dude, I watch that shit sucked, dude.
It's
sucked.
Not the writing rooms of old, and you know this. It's girls.
I think
girls make Black Mirror. Show me the whole fucking writing screen, or the writing crew. Yeah. I guarantee you 90% girls, maybe 2 white guys.
That was a sad.
We think of the sickest shit, dude. Is what it is.
Yeah, but imagine if I could put on like a Vision Pro and experience like whatever these fucking crazy dreams you have are.
It was weird.
Yeah, like I can't. If I'm doing it, I don't remember any of it.
I was teetering off, but I couldn't fully go into the dream. And I was like, fuck it, I'm going to wake up.
Yeah, yeah.
But Goya, please.
Oh, yeah. Well, fucking. He was like a regular. So there's this whole thing back in the day where you would be picked up by the royals to be a portrait painter. That was like what you could become.
You're fully ascended if you're...
You're not even fully ascended. You're not even one of the masters.
Oh, fuck.
You might attempt to be one, but you could just be a court painter. Now you're getting paid.
It's like an apprenticeship.
Not an apprentice. Like, you're past apprentice.
Mm-hmm.
This would be like intermediate barbell. Like, you've won
come fuck them.
You've won a contest.
I get what you're saying.
You're not a novice.
I get that.
You've won before.
Just continue.
So... Like, so Goya was like an average dude. He was good as shit at fucking doing it.
Yeah.
But then he went deaf and got paranoid.
What?
Dude.
I would.
Then he starts doing the black paintings. He starts doing this crazy shit. Gets real political. Starts doing like political satires. Like he.
Hilarious.
He goes off the deep end.
What year is this?
I don't know.
Chuck it out there.
Can't remember, but.
Based off the vibe.
I want to say. It was the late 1700s, early 1800s.
Right, no one's wrong here.
He gets fucked up by the Napoleonic Wars.
Okay.
So he like says like he gets pissed about the Napoleon Wars. And he starts painting like this fucking insane shit.
What are like?
And so is, like, they blamed
I'm
it on
them up. Continue
they,
talking.
They blamed it on lead poisoning. Well, they blamed it on syphilis. They tried to do all this shit on
but
them.
There was lead in the cups.
But they make their own paint back then, and when you're making like the old like Kremnitz white, all of these old whites are lead based. So you're grinding up lead constantly.
They grind it up?
Yeah, man. Lead paint. Lead white is like lead. Like when you want the real white.
Oh, bro. He does the Kronos painting?
Yeah, yeah.
Was this when he was deaf?
Yeah, so he was deaf and he
what
got real.
What the fuck, bro?
So, dude, he ascends. Just imagine this. Back in the day, like this would have been like a celebrity job.
Why are all his paintings of eating kids?
No, I mean, you're just looking at like the one version.
Oh.
Yeah. So. Saturn devouring his kids is a common painting. Of multiple artists.
Oh, for some reason, just went right to that when I searched Goya.
Yeah, Goya did. Yeah, Goya was a beast with that one.
Dude, imagine, like, everyone's just going around. Like, people don't even understand full colors yet. And this dude's like, this is what's in my head.
Yep.
And everyone's yep. like, dude, what the fuck?
Dude, he's got, like, lithograph. He's got cool, like, lithographs and drawings and stuff. The drawings are cooler.
What are lithographs?
They're like prints. You draw on a stone and then you etch it.
Yes, this guy's on drugs.
Yeah, well, what happened was, so he was a regular-ass dude, just a hardworking painter.
Yeah.
And they don't know if it's, like, lead accumulation or syphilis or whatever.
Likes goats, bro.
But he ascends to the higher levels, where now he's chilling with the elites. But he's deaf. So he's fucking paranoid as fuck.
Dude, I would lose my fucking mind.
Yeah, dude.
But, like, do they know
they
why?
They have all these ways to make paint. Like, when you're, like, they didn't go to the store. They had to make their own shit. So they would get minerals and all this stuff like cadmium red, the yellows. They're all like real bad chemicals. Like Vincent Van Gogh.
So they're like the OG painters. Now you're like, dude, paint oil fucking blows. Like this shit sucks.
They had to make their own juice, dude, before they even started. So
that's wild.
If you were like an apprentice, you were just making paint.
Yeah, so you're like, fucking so fully gone.
Back in the old days, in the painters' rooms of old, there would be
painters
there
rooms.
Would be a team of dudes that would just be like whipping up linseed oils and whipping up fucking pigments. But those guys got bodied by all this stuff.
Yeah.
And then if you want to be a forger, you have to know how to do it.
What's a forger?
A forger is like a guy that will make up. Like, there was a dude who was trying to remember where this guy was from. Denmark. Or no, Holland. So Holland is where the Dutch masters are.
Right.
Right.
The good fine paints of Europe.
These are the
Hollandic.
The Dutch are the guys that invented oil painting. So, like, if you're a young Dutch painter, you want to become a master.
Obviously.
And there was this one dude, his name's like Van Meergen or something, and he was almost good. And he had a show, and all the critics were like, you suck.
Oh.
Right? So he fucking loses his shit, pissed off. Now he's spurred on by vengeance for the rest of his days.
Obviously.
He goes to the French Riviera, and he becomes
villain arc.
Yeah, so his villain arc begins. And he goes to the French Riviera to do portrait painting, because that's how you get paid.
Yeah.
You get rich people, and you make them look good. So, but he, while he's doing this, he's like, fuck them. I'm going to make Vermeers. I'm going to make a Vermeer. Vermeer is a famous Dutch. He's the Dutch master of old.
Oh, okay. So he's right? going to make their Vermeer.
So he's going to copy one. He's going to make one that they think they found a Vermeer. Right? But it'll
It's a trap.
But it'll be him, you know? And then he'll unveil as the villain.
Or oh, what a cocksucker.
He'll come out and be like, actually, it's me. I'm a master.
This is Ashton Kutcher's great-great-great-grandfather.
So what happens is none of this pans out.
Fuck.
Right? But Van Meergen does find a buyer for this painting. And he claims it's a Vermeer. And it's during... We're in 1937 Europe.
Okay.
So...
Tell me this gets to Hitler.
So there's this guy, Hermann Göring.
Dude,
and
fuck.
Göring fucking says, give me that Vermeer. I'll give you all these paintings from the folk, from the Germans.
Wow.
So he trades one of his forgeries for 170-something paintings from Göring.
Yes.
Right? He buys nightclubs, buys fucking real estate. He's balling. So from like 37 to 45, this guy's living like a king.
Yes.
Because the Nazis hooked him up. Well, the Nazis lost, and that dude was a collaborator.
Oh.
Right? So he,
oh, fuck, dude.
So the Dutch are like, fuck you, dude. You took one of our Vermeers, and you sold it to the Nazis. So now this the villain arc is back on.
Right? So this guy's just fucking like, yes.
Villain arc's back on.
You idiot.
And he goes, ah, yes. That's not a Vermeer. That's one of mine. And they go, bullshit. Let me see you do it. So the mainstream media of the time, the newspapers are like, love this headline. The man's painting for his life. So this trial. So he's, first of all, while he was a nightclub dude, he became a morphine addict.
Damn.
So he needs morphine to get through the day.
Holy fuck.
So armed.
What a mess.
So, dude, he's locked up. But, dude, this is pure villain arc shit.
Yeah.
He's locked up. The guards have to give him a small dose of morphine so he can get through the day. And his trial was him painting. They wanted him to copy a Vermeer, and he said, fuck that. I'll paint a new painting that you think is a Vermeer. And they gave him his paints, and they gave him his morphine, and he painted to prove that he wasn't a Nazi collaborator, that he tricked Goering, right, and all this shit. And he ends up doing a year for being a forger, but he does not get busted for being a Nazi collaborator.
Jesus, that's awesome. Does he get to keep all of his shit?
I mean, I don't know. He just did a year.
Holy fuck.
I don't know what happened to him afterwards, but
that is the ultimate fucking prank.
But he was like going to the Mediterranean and finding like lapis lazuli and like all these weird old minerals to grind up. And he would buy old paintings, like shit paintings from like the Middle Ages.
Touch them up.
So he could have the canvas that would prove that it was that old. So there's a dude like
and
Rembrandt.
And forge them. Oh, fuck.
Yeah, like insane. Rembrandt. Like there's dudes, like there's paintings. There's guys, the old masters that are, the paintings are so simple. All you got to do is get the paints. There was only like six colors.
Get a canvas old enough.
Get the canvas old enough and you can do this. You could make, so a lot of, they said like there might only be 27 Rembrandts and all the rest of them are forges.
Who's the one and that like had too, a school that like
everyone? All of them. Titian had a school, Rembrandt had a school. So also, all of the young apprentices, they wanted to get paid. So when they come up, they're not going to use their own name.
Obviously.
And this was like a custom. So like this wasn't, like we call them forgeries now. But back then, it was totally cool to be like, yeah, I'm from Team Rembrandt.
Yeah.
Rembrandt.
Rembrandt or die, yeah, bitch.
Exactly.
I know, there's
kind of like the modern day jiu-jitsu schools.
True.
You're like, I'm a Gracie. Whatever.
Yeah, it makes fucking, that's, it is insane the amount of money for like that paint. Or like the paintings and all that shit bring in, never made sense to me, never will.
Well, I mean, like Hunter thought it would save him.
But dude, did you see he got charged?
Yes.
Little shit. He got
segue into another subject.
You're fucking,
I'm
bro,
getting better at this.
God damn it. Yeah, he fucking, they did all this shit while they're fucking indicting Trump, dude. It doesn't make any sense. Hunter did everything wrong and they indicted Trump. Like, dude, they're hitting him with a gun charge, tax evasion, and some other shit. Little pee-pee smack and stuff on that A-venture.
Yeah. You know what's funny is that they're going after Trump hard now.
Hard as shit.
Like, the media.
Won't get me this time. Lock him up. I don't give a fuck.
Not at all, man.
Lock him up. Not going to get me to fucking go into capitals. I don't give a fuck.
It's kind of like, from what I've seen now, it looks like they have been taking it really easy on him.
On Trump? I mean, dude, the guy's out there giving fucking speeches and shit.
Yeah.
He bought a whole fucking Miami breakfast place lunch.
Well, he just did a deal with the Saudis that they're pissed off about.
Trump did?
Yeah, Trump just did like
with Liv? He's way into Liv Golf.
I don't think this is Liv Golf. It might be. It's in the Oman.
Oh, dude, you could tell me.
Allegedly, that's
you,
a country.
Yeah, sure, whatever. Indians live there, whatever the fuck you call them. What were you saying about fucking McGregor getting dark?
Oh, I just watched the final episode of that McGregor thing, and like, I was so pumped because he's like, I want to be. He's training so hard, he feels like he's brand new.
Yes.
And I was telling O'Connor, like, fuck, dude, that's what I want to feel like.
Obviously.
I want to feel like I'm new, you know what I mean? And then he got rocked by Poirier.
Yeah, he fucked his leg up bad.
And you watch it, and then you watch him in the locker room afterwards, and he's fucked up.
Is he crying?
Borderline.
Take a
he's
lot.
Fucked up, and then he just. To me, it's the only way a man can handle it.
What?
Is you're fucked up, you're crab swelling.
If you talk, you'll cry.
he's sitting there next to his chick, and he's definitely fucked up, and his chick's fucking doing that shit where they're just next to you quiet with a weird face.
Yeah.
Everyone's quiet.
Yep.
And he's talking it out, and he's talking it out, and then he just goes, "What the fuck was that?" And then it's like, yeah, that's going to stop you from getting the shaky lip.
Holy fuck.
Yeah. And then he had to do a press con. He had, dude, he had to get what do they call those things?
The Timmy crutches or whatever.
Those things. He had to put those on. He had to put a suit on and get those on and go out and give a press conference afterwards.
You know how bad that shit probably hurts, dude?
Yeah, man.
Snapping your fucking bone on someone.
And he's such a, like, he trained in Dubai. Like, at the end of this, like, he was fucking, he is the sport.
Yeah.
You know, and he's, like, congratulating Poirier on having hot sauce. Like, I love what you're doing, dude. You're doing the right thing. Like, we got to pump this up. He's like the Arnold of MMA.
Lots of schmay. Yeah, it's crazy, like, how much money those dudes start blowing on fucking training and shit.
What do you mean?
Like, dude, why wouldn't you just build, like, if I was those dudes, I would just build my own little facility and just go hang.
This was during COVID, so they had to do weird shit.
Yeah, they locked them out, too.
They showed the tests. All of his trainers are like, this is a very serious disease, and we test for it, and they showed, dude, in the fucking Netflix thing, obviously Netflix, Obama's Netflix, showing tons of Q-tips. Q-tips going into babies, dude. Going into his kid's back of his throat.
Never got one.
You know what's on the end of that Q-tip.
Microchips. Never got one.
Yeah.
You started talking about COVID, dude. It's like a World War II guy thinking about Normandy. It fucks me up.
Yeah, you're a draft dodger. You never even fought in the war.
I know. I fought in the war. I was front lines, fucking on the ones and twos. I was talking to a dude the other day. Like, you couldn't drive into Delaware if you're from PA, but people from, I don't even give a fuck. People from Delaware go to PA and fucking go about their day freely. Shit made no fucking sense.
Yeah, yeah.
And people are still fucking telling
you. Yeah, there's a whole thing in it with getting tested, and then you had to go into a bubble. So before the fight, they had to go into a bubble. Like, all this shit, man.
The NBA had, that. It was literally like.
They must have been laughing about it when the cameras are off.
Obviously.
Yeah.
The NBA had end racism on their sidelines, dude.
NFL, too.
And they all did. But the NBA had the bubble where they all had a fucking say, and it was like, BLM, end racism, all for a criminal. Literally makes no sense. If you say it now, if you say it now, you're a dick, and let's talk about something else. Yeah. There's a war going on. You're a dick.
Yeah, they put a gun to a pregnant woman's stomach.
Pretty shitty.
Pretty shitty thing to do, dude.
Yeah, I was thinking about it. I've been getting hit with fucking just memories of what the fuck happens. Like, dude, you guys are dicks for even, like, I would say imagine, sorry.
Like, post the media hype and all that stuff, and, like, 15, 20 years later, you got to explain some of these murals.
Oh. It's like, dude, like, no joke. It would be like if I was on right now recording, like, 2 more weeks, it's going to be biblical.
I mean, there's people still doing it.
Sure, but I'm saying, like, that's how, like, if you're still going along with this, like, racism's the biggest problem. Dude, Twitter is fucking with me. I watched a video of this refugee fucking walking down the street and just grabbed the little girl and an old lady out of their house and slammed them on the fucking ground and then just kept walking.
Yeah, I never fucked with Twitter and then that thing with
Hotez,
and I saw that, and the vitriol.
Oh, it's crazy, dude.
Like, the fucking hate that goes on, like, Twitter.
Bunch of Mike Mentzers, dude.
Fuck Mike Mentzer, dude. I can't. You're telling me to listen to tape, too.
He's a fucking goat.
Fuck that dude, man.
Dude, he's angry. Like,
he's pissed off at what?
The fucking peons and the plebes. The only thing that fucks me up, he starts talking about the moon and all that shit, which... that's his bag.
We landed on the moon.
I'm not going to fucking say he's wrong, but the guy makes fucking sense. Like, imagine if people were interested enough in painting that, like, you did paint competitions and everyone's like, no, he's doing painting right.
I wanted this to exist.
But I'm saying, imagine how you would sound.
They have electrician competitions.
Yeah, imagine how you would sound if you went to those painting competitions. You never fucking won, even though you knew you were the GOAT.
What if I could set up a booth with just a small 90... Get someone that's nice on the tape, just a true fucking 90, and then I just sit there and teach people the razor in a booth.
But
hey, man, I get paid?
What I'm saying is, how do you think you would sound after years of people telling you to shut up and that you're wrong about
you lost.
But I'm just
when
saying,
did he win?
You made tapes of fucking how you paint a room, your new system of how to paint a room. Would you sound happy if everyone starts listening, like, dude, he didn't win? He's just a painter. He's just a painter. He's not Nolan.
Let him be a misanthrope. Let him be a curmudgeon. The only
get off the books, dude. What the fuck?
The only good thing he did was Dorian Yates.
Dude, stop it. You should have some respect for your elders, dude. You're such a young gun. It's not even funny. Have some respect for the guys that came before you. You're standing on the shoulders of 300-pound, 5'6" giants.
So it's funny you say that. There, I looked into that, too. Standing on the shoulders of giants was a slam that...
Fuck off.
Isaac Newton... So Isaac Newton was in a battle with this other
funny
dude.
You should mention that.
In a battle with this other dude. And I can't remember his name. It begins with an H. But they were in like a science battle. And this dude with his name's an H, he claims that Hitler. Newton was stealing his shit.
Obviously, dude.
And Newton was like, no, I was standing on the shoulders of giants, right? But the dude that he's talking about was like 5 feet tall, even with a hunchback and bug eyes.
Totally.
So he was just slamming that dude. So that whole quote is just to slam a short guy.
I rescind then, because yeah. A lot of bodybuilders aren't real tall.
I'm sure he came back with, like, okay, virgin, but yeah. We don't know. We don't have that correspondence from back then.
Yeah, damn. I mean, dude, Mensa shit makes sense. We're going on Dorian.
I'm sure, like, I was told by LeBron to do fucking HIT.
High-intensity interval training, obviously.
And you're saying that Mensa invented it?
No. He's just a huge proponent of it. Dude, it goes back to, like, fucking, like, Russians and shit. And, like, that's where you, like, all this shit, like, Tommy Pope was talking about. Like, there was workout plans. Like, this is a Bulgarian workout. Like, this is the
This is where we're getting Romanian deadlifts from.
Yes.
Okay, I got you.
They stem from Romania.
Okay.
But, I mean, all this shit is sick. It's just good to, you know, eat.
I want to meet Mr. Smith.
His
machine's gonna
the inventor
fix
of the
my
Smith machine.
He's gonna fix my shoulder.
It is fucked up. They don't have more Smith machines. Anyone worth their salt tells you to get on a fucking Smith machine. Hardos and Sarms goblins will be like, no, I'm gonna do free weight bag. Like, dude, you hit the shoulder Smith machine, you're much better off. Even building chest, it's pretty good.
There's something about those, like, SARMS kids that looks like they want to be, like, influencers or something.
Oh, they all do.
They're hanging out
by the kids are
cable.
Literally getting perms.
They're hanging out by... Oh, is that what that is?
It's perms, yes.
I thought it was, like, a cope for curly-haired kids to get that haircut.
No. These kids are getting perms.
Well, yeah, they're just, like, standing around bullshitting. They're not even, like, working out.
I mean, dude, what you saw was, like, a level one SARMS goblin. They get up to, like, where they're kind of jacked and it's crazy,
yeah.
But they have no strength. They're but an egg.
So what happens? Like, you're telling me that if you
they're research chemicals.
If you take this if you take these supplements, you get these muscles you can't grow without them, like these shoulders you're talking about and stuff.
Yeah.
So if I see that, then I know they're not natties. Is
not
that
necessarily
deal?
Like dudes. You can develop great shoulders without fucking steroids, but if you see dudes and like shit's just not making sense, like. The dieting and the amount of time you would have to put into exercise to look like that, it's like there's a good chance you're on some sort of gear. But the SARMS goblins, it's hard because, dude, you could be a jacked kid.
I'm still learning, like, gym etiquette, and I see those guys. I don't want to look at anyone because I feel like you're bringing me in there, and people are looking at me like when you look at a dog, and you're like, you're not going to put them down?
I mean, come on,
you know
what
I mean?
you see
everyone there is so young and hot.
No,
all the hip thrusts.
They
lay on that bar and do those hip thrusts, bro.
Then you get into bed with them. They're dead fish, bro. What's up with that? What's up with all the hip thrust, ladies? And you just dead fish in the bed. A lot of humping for no reason.
Oh, yeah.
A lot of humping. They don't do a fucking goddamn.
I don't know how that's a workout, but I mean,
it
again,
is. Try
I don't
it. James
know.
Harding, or not James Harding, Jesus Christ.
I don't know. I like, I'm telling you, man, I'm just figuring out now I'm supposed to be flexing certain parts of my body.
Yeah.
Like, I don't, like...
Dude, you've been lifting
you've been
for, like,
doing
a month.
It. You've been doing it your whole life.
Be like me, like, dude, why when can't I doing, cut in without tape? You've been painting for a month, dude. Give it a break.
Yeah, when we were doing the chest press and stuff, the first couple times I was doing it with my arms.
Yeah.
Like, everything I was doing was with my arms. That's why you're like, dude, you're moving your arms. I'm like, yeah. How else am I supposed to do this?
It's, yeah, the ultimate stretch, yeah. The ultimate contraction. I mean, all you have to remember is...
The
you
burnout
want the,
thing is psychotic, though.
Why?
I mean, I'm just saying, like, every time we do it, I don't like it because
I hate it.
We do the one burnout, and then you say, but now it's time for the triceps, and then it's another burnout.
Did you think I wanted to put 100-pound dumbbells on the incline? No. I had to. I have no other fucking choice. I have to fucking exert the effort. I could have did 90s and looked like a fucking beast. Probably got fucking
Well, there's
10.
Another dude, like, two benches down from
that
you,
other beast.
And he was throwing around 80s listening to music, having a good time.
Yes.
I know that if you felt you were taking out the hundreds at the time,
I was literally it took everything in me not to be like, bro, obviously this is the next step. He was on flat bench with 80s. Like, yeah. Obviously that dude wanted 100-pound dumbbells.
Yeah, yeah.
He saw, but that's the thing. I wasn't sit there. You know that shit's going on, and it's not you being a dick. Like, you know you have to wrap up.
Yeah, like, I'm not in that world. Like, I'm not noticing this stuff. I'm just, like, you're, like, point and shoot. Like, now you go to the lap machine. I'm like, okay, now I go over there.
Yeah.
I'm still a noob. I'm an egg.
That fucking Asian bitch that let the other guy get on the Smith machine when I fucking asked her.
You misunderstood that conversation, and you're hating her. I heard the actual conversation. That guy rolled up. He had his headphones
in. She should stand up for herself more.
He had the buds in, and he was like, and he's saying, like, oh, yeah, he's telling her, don't worry, leave it, I'll move it. And she said to him, I'm not done yet.
Yeah.
So you assume that she was letting him on the machine. She was saying, like, dude, stop, don't move that. She was just walking over to get, like, another 25 or something.
Yeah, that pisses me off, though.
Whatever, dude.
You shouldn't be fucking, I mean, or at least say you can work in. All these chicks
fucking work in mean.
Like, we can fucking go in with her.
What?
If she's on the Smith machine and she sees that there's two hungry men looking for it as well.
Oh, and then she like gets in the rotation.
Yes.
Oh, that'd be cool.
But dude, thing is, I would have said no, but it's like a fucking on the road. If you cut me off, if you give me the sorry, all is forgiven.
Yeah.
Just offer me the work in, and I'll say no to that.
You're cursing her out, and I'm telling you, dude.
Like, not to her. To me and you, we were talking about
it. We stormed out of the gym, and you were like, fuck that chick. And I was like, dude, she's literally not done yet. That dude.
She should get off the Smith machine.
She should have. I mean, she was there the whole
fucking
time.
Fucking 10 pounds on the Smith machine, dude.
The
fuck
whole
off.
Workout, yeah. Just to hump.
Literally just to do thrusts.
Yeah.
Burnout thrusts. Dude, they have a fucking machine for that. It's the booty builder that the stupid idiots from the fucking gym bought
for
the
thoughts. There's like two booty builders, but one Smith machine.
Dude, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah. Well, maybe we're at the wrong gym. This is what I was saying to you before.
You have to go to a temple gym.
You know what I mean?
Snooze. I do everything right there, and they ignore me.
They don't ignore you, dude. All those chicks are checking you out.
Oh,
the whole time I'm there, they're checking you out. You are, like, autistic. Like, you mumble, and your eyes are down. Like, I'm not a communication wizard, but it's hard. You're giving me directions.
Because I'm trying to think at the same
time.
And
it's hard for me to understand what you're saying. I'm 1 foot away from you.
But, it's like Jedi training.
Yeah.
I'm trying to get telekinesis going.
I'm picking it up, but I'm saying, like, while I'm trying to decipher you.
What the fuck am I doing with my life?
Like, because I'm watching them look at you. I'm like, oh, damn, all these chicks are checking out Bill, you know?
They know.
I'm just saying.
I fucking love my body. I love my soulmate.
Yeah, you just have your hat. You just have your hat down, right? And you're just fucking pumping.
Pumping iron,
staring into nothing.
That's why you're like, oh yeah, going there, fucking the chicks, dude. They could be naked for all I care. I want the pump.
Yeah,
I became a soldier in this fucking war. I've seen those thoughts come and go, and it's not like because that's what they get. They fucking hike the pants up their ass, and it's like, oh,
yeah.
She's on the Smith machine, bro. Don't bother, bitch. Get the fuck off that thing if all you're going to do is...
Well, the other one today was doing it without a machine.
I know. Yeah. There's no reason to fucking have a Smith machine for those fucking workouts she was doing.
I would love to go to them and then be like, hey, touch my arm and feel it while I'm doing it.
Yeah.
And be like, this is for me.
You know what she's going to say?
You're
an old pervert.
I know, but I'm just saying, you know what I mean?
Obviously, yeah.
Like, just so that they would know. There's people out there that need it. I should actually be on the NovaCare side.
Nah,
I should be in the physical therapy side.
No. You're an able-bodied man. Stop trying to fucking say you're handicapped. Unless you want to get a fucking handicap thing, we can start parking the sick places.
Yeah, yeah.
That would be fucking sick, actually, if you got a handicap thing. Well, I think the boys are good. Well, everyone, come on now.
Well, that's good.